Kamale University, the only public university in Chigezi sub-region, southwestern Uganda, was marred by protests as students, donning in their academic gowns, voiced their grievances against a surcharge increase. Their demand for clarity regarding the sudden increase resulted in visible unrest at campus.
Surcharge is on our neck, is on the portal every time, every day. And when we try to go to like, responsible offices, they try to rebuke us as if we are nothing, as if we don't have what we can say.
If I pay accidentally that surcharge and rate registration, yet the time has not been what initiated. Do they reverse that money? Where does it go?
We are the public that pays the largest amount of money in other universities, yet we have the poorest services.
Police intervened to maintain law and order on the campus premises. Chukwu Shaba Amos, the Dean of Students, acknowledged the students' concerns and expressing understanding of their fraction. He assured students that the university was committed to resolving the issue.
Things of the systems are also not in one's control. Some other times, the system is not. And when that happens, then many other things do happen.
In an official announcement, Professor Joy Costens Kwesiga, the university vice-chancellor, responded to the protest. She explained that the university senate recommended the removal of surcharges due to the late payment of fees. Instead, a late registration fee of 50,000 Ugandan shillings per semester was proposed. However, the recommendation is pending approval by the university council in its upcoming meeting. According to Geoffrey Sempuju, the head of communication at the university, a meeting between university management and select student leaders took place to address the concerns raised during the protest. The university committee now anticipates the decision of the university council, hoping for a resolution that balances financial requirements with the students' demand for fairness and transparency in fee-related matters.
And we do believe that we shall continue to harmoniously maintain that kind of practice. And at the end of the day, we want to believe that we should be able to deliver on our mandates and ensure that our students get the attention they deserve in order to become professionals that they should be, and training in a very free and convenient environment.
The situation at the university remains tense, with students closely watching developments and waiting for a final resolution from the university council. Report compiled by Job Namanye for the news.